So in stiffening girder,
we have discussed girders which are stiffened. But I would like to give some brief.
First of all, tell me, what is meaning of girder? What is girder? It is a beam. That is equal. It is equivalent to beam. Something different. Suppose it is river, yeah, valley, or any obstacle. Okay. Here, ground. Here it is ground. Okay. We want to go from this one place to this one place. What we will do? What we will do? We will place a panel. We will place a horizontal panel. Which will carry the traffic. Which may carry the traffic. In this ground, air ground, so this is the passage. So this is what? This is the passage for vehicle. Passage for vehicle. And that panel is basically girder. That panel is girder, nothing else. Clear? Beam. So it has this length L. What is this? This length L and this width W. So the load of vehicle will be over that girder. And that load has to be transferred safely to the ground. Ground ka? Where is the ground? Here. We have to transfer moving load. Suppose these vehicles may be at any place, no? Vehicles may be at any place. So these total load of vehicles we have to transfer not at the water, not at the valley. Here, either this or this. Clear? This is our objective. This is our objective. And for that, we are designing the suspension bridge. We are designing the suspension bridge. For suspension bridge has some limitations, some benefits also. They have some benefits, they have some disadvantages also. So to place that panel over this obstacle, we are doing this panel. Suppose this panel is EF GF. So this panel is being this panel point A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D. These are the points in atmosphere.
at certain elevation,
and this point has to restrain. Okay,
hawa mein, in it open atmosphere, how you can have a point A which is not able to move in vertical and horizontal direction. A B C D, these are four points which are open atmosphere, and at that point no horizontal and vertical motion is permitted. How it can be possible? By means of they, all these points will be provided by means of providing this type of thing. And what is this? So point A is what? These are the points. These are the points A, B. These are the points. Get everybody? Points are this. In open atmosphere, then it may have certain height. It may have certain height. Okay. So by passing a cable A, B, C, D, they may have at same level, they may not be at the same level. Okay. Here I am taking at different elevation. So if a cable is, the cable has been passed over this point A and B, and these are here ground. So at suitable place during the construction of the suspension bridge, this is the first step is to make the pairs, means point A, point B, point C, point D. We have to make this first step. Okay, after that what we will do? We will place this cable. And after that, what we will do? At this point also, we have to make this also. Two cables. The next step of that work will be hanging. We have to hang this. We can hang this one part and this one part. This is the part. That is it. Doing this procedure, that panel will be completely hanged. Let everybody, below that panel, water or anything, it is one process here. This process, horizontal process, can be there. Let everybody. So this is the procedure. Now, since load, we have to transfer this load of the vehicle. Okay, and suppose at here higher load is there, okay, then suppose here it is the higher load, heavy load, then what will happen? Heavy load yahan pe aa gaya, more reaction will produce here, then the shape will be different. Therefore, to provide, now it is the girder. Now I am going to make a system which can transfer the load to that cable
which can transfer the load, that cable by this uniformly distributed load W
through suspenders. If that girder is supported, by these vertical, these are vertical members basically. These are the vertical members. Okay. If load of this load of vehicles over that panel is coming on the cable in the form of UDL through that suspender, then that procedure is called as stiffening. That procedure is called as stiffening, and that girder is known as stiffened girder. Okay, the same thing will be at this side also.
These are the vertical suspenders, and the load will be WE here.
That is what. So कहाँ पे था? Yes, yes.
This procedure transmitting the equivalent load on the cable, this is called as stiffening process. And one more thing is also there. The shape must be parabolic. We have to arrange that load. We have to place this panel through that vertical hangers in such a way which transmit equivalent load WE, and shape is parabolic. There is some importance why we are interested to have parabolic type of shape. There is some meaning. The meaning is if we have this two hinge arms, clear, and I have UDL W, then we know very well what is the value of horizontal WLU square by 8H. If this is the replace H by D, hai na? If this is D, right, it is also H. And if this is point P, X comma Y, okay, means this horizontal distance X, this vertical distance Y, if we are calculating the moment, then it will be mu X minus H into Y. By putting value of mu X and H Y, it will becomes to zero. That's why we are interested. To this shape. This shape is effective, but no, it will not have any bending at any every segment will have the zero value of bending moment if this continuous UDL is there. The same thing is also applicable for three hinge type of arch. If we have three hinge arch, then the moment at different interval can also be will be zero. Value of Mx is zero. Tell everybody, we know very well that bending moment, that the shear force is the rate of change of moment, if moment is zero, then shear force will also be zero. Means shear force and bending moment both will be zero. So this is the benefit. This procedure is stiffening. I am just trying to define the procedure of stiffening. This is the shape of cable should be ensured. Should be ensured that the shape, parabolic shape, should not be disturbed. And one more thing, WE must be there. Okay, so that if the panel is fully occupied with, say for example, million tons of load, then effective bending moment at any point it will be zero. Million tons of load is there through that panel, then we do not need to worry, means how much strength, bending strength at different place of the girder should be there. Okay, we need not to worry. Clear? That should be very much clear to you. And due to that reason, the dead load of the girder is not considered for shear force and bending moment. Clear to everybody? What is the dead load? Dead load will be the self weight of girder, and it will be UDL. It will be what? It will be uniformly distributed. And if it is uniformly distributed, so this type of thing will be there. If this type of thing there, the shear force and bending moment will be zero. It means what? We do not need to consider dead load. There is no need to analyze the shear force and bending moment for dead load type of thing or UDL type of thing. If our moving load is truck, and if this is L, and suppose the moving load is continuous UDL with its length more than L, okay, and when it is fully occupied on the panel, then that load need not to be considered. That I want to tell you. When this load is fully covered, if it is partially, then that there is need to consider. Clear to everybody? Now, what will be the parameter to design this panel? Come to this. What will be the parameter to design this panel? Since this is a girder, means girder means beam, and we know very well that major force are what? Bending moment and shear force. Therefore, we need to find bending moment and shear force at different section. At what? Here, what should be the thickness? What will be the strength of that panel? Kitna mota hona chahiye? Okay, na? Rigidity kitni honi? That will be dependent upon bending moment and shear force due to moving load over there. Clear to everybody? And when it is, the load is fully covered with this, that will not be considered. And for moving load, this type of thing is not generally observed. For self type of weight, it is being observed. Clear to everybody? So, ek note karke aap zarur likhne. Reason. For the calculation of shear force and ye, pehle to ye itna likh. Ye. In just a minute. इसमें लिखें हेडिंग डाल के लिखें इसमें एनालिसिस ये एनालिसिस डेटा फॉर डिजाइन एनालिसिस डेटा फॉर डिजाइन व्हाट विल बी नंबर वन इट विल बी बेंडिंग मोमेंट एट एनी सेक्शन बेंडिंग मोमेंट एट एनी सेक्शन एंड सेकंड वन विल बी शियर फोर्स एट एनी section.
It means our objective for analyzing the stiffening girder will be to calculate the value of bending moment and shear force. Is over? This will be the object. What we will calculate in stiffening girder. We will calculate bending moment and shear force. Here, everybody. And what another type of thing, what we will analyze. We can plot IL for bending moment and shear force at any desired section, x is equal to a. That two type of, three type of thing we will do. Clear everybody? IL for bending moment and shear force I will not discuss. Why I will not discuss? Because it is similar to 2-inch arch or 3-inch arch. It is exactly same. It's comparison to 3-inch arch and 2-inch arch. I will tell you how you will can calculate the value of shear force or bending moment at any section in stiffening girder. Okay. So till date we did the analysis. We have done the analysis for this one part. Okay, this one analysis and yeah, this type of thing. What is this? This is the cable, separate cable. And what is yeah, this one cable? What is the name? No, this is not main cable. This is anchor cable. Anchor cable, anchor ho raha na. What is main cable? Main cable is this one. Main cable is, main cable is, it is suspension cable. It is also called as suspension cable. Main cable or suspension cable. And these vertical, what are these vertical? These are the suspenders. Clear? So we did the analysis for cable part. Okay. And we have calculated the value of the pressure force coming on the pairs. We did not numerical type of thing we have not calculated, but in theory we have told you what will be the value of the pressure force exerting over the pairs. Okay. That type of question are also being asked in your exam. So do that question. Okay. Today what we will do? We will do lower part. Means this one part. Lower part. Okay. And one more thing. What is here? There is a ground. Clear to everybody? Now I am making the simplest figure. This is the actual figure which is on the ground. Now I am going to make the figure for a stiffening girder. This is the okay. This point is A, this point is B. They may be same level, they may not be at the same level. And this point is E and F. If this portion is this point is suppose E, this is F, this is suppose G, if this is suppose H. Clear to everybody? E point is at the ground, F point is at the ground, G, H. Oh, and for analysis purpose, this complete panel has not to be considered. And entire panel has not to be considered, only this one part, one side part has to be considered. Clear to everybody? only one side of part is considered, means A, B, D, A, B, this one,
E, F,
that I have written. Okay, clear to everybody? So, and this is supposed to be what? Hinge. Is supposed to be hinge. A and B are open atmosphere, but due to pair, it is pairs, it is not going to move in either X or Y direction. Horizontal or vertical movement is not permitted. And through suspenders, this load is coming out, which is known as W. Load is coming out, which is known as W. Right, everybody? And we know very well that E and F are the point. E and F are the point. Kahan pe? On the ground. So this point is E. This point is E. This point is F. Clear? Since E and F, these are the points at the ground. Okay, if we want to make the free body diagram, of this girder only, okay, so we will have, this thing. WE and this. Okay. And this is EF. And since it is supported, this point is, since point is at the ground, therefore reaction must be there, and that reaction will be for what? It will be for VA, it will be for VB, and VB is this, VA is this. It must be clear to everybody. Clear to everybody? Because the vertical load which is coming here, that has to be transferred. That is exactly at below the point, na? A and B, A and E, they are at the vertical level, at the same vertical level. So exactly same load. V will be this vertical, VB. Summation of all, it is what? It is zero. Let everybody. Summation of all is zero. It is the free body diagram. What I have made? This is the FBD. This is the FBD without load of, without traffic load, without moving load, yeah, without traffic load, that we have made. It does not have any traffic load, moving load nahi hai. Clear everybody? But it will have moving load also, because this is a passes. Therefore, this girder has to be supported the moving load. Clear to everybody? And when suppose this is W1, this is suppose W2, this is suppose W3, and so on. Many load may be there. So at here, this point E, this point F. What will be that? Since E and F, they are the point at the ground. Therefore,
vertical reaction must be there
to counterbalance W1, W2 and W3.
And say it is vertical reaction VE, say it is vertical reaction VF.
Therefore, this girder can be analyzed with the combination of these two. First one figure is, I have made,
this is FBD without
any load. And what is this? This is the FBD. Only for
the FBD, only for load, traffic load, yes.
Now I can erase this. Now, if we want to analyze the Stephen girder, then we have to consider
which one? If this is figure 1, if this is figure 2. So we have to consider
these two figures. Okay. And one more thing, stiffening girder can be
2 hinged, can be 3 hinged or 2 hinged.
It can be either 2 hinged or 3 hinged. Okay. What is the meaning of 2 hinged and 3 hinged?
3
hinged. Yes. 3. It will be supported at 3 places. Means, this girder, it is 2 hinge stiffened girder. If I want to make this as a 3 hinge stiffened girder, then what I should do? At the lowest point. If this is the lowest point, okay, then I have to place
internal.
I have to consider internal. Okay, internal hinge means if load is coming, so aise ho sakta hai na, it may bend. Okay na, it may bend. So no need to make here. Okay, this one figure. Okay, these are two figure. So I am considering for 3 hinge. First case one,
for 3 hinge. These are two cases basically. So case one, for 3 hinge. 3 hinge, stiffened girder. For 3 hinge, stiffened girder.
Means having this internal hinge at the point.
Okay.
Acha, tell me,
what is the dip at that point? What is the dip? Dip is measured from
That axis. You know very well, na? I have told you, na? It is not like this.
Okay, na?
Line drawing. Okay,
dip at this point, kya hoga? This one will be the dip. Clear? At this one will be the dip.
That I have made too. If it is at the same level, B point is here, then no problem. Okay. For 3 is stiffening order.
I am going to calculate bending moment at any section X. Bending moment at any section X.
Why I am going to calculate bending moment? Why not another type of forces? Why not another type of forces? It is because this is girder, and in girder only bending moment and shear force can be possible. Therefore, I am going to calculate bending moment at any section. Okay. This is my section. This is my section. My section is this. Section is this, which is at a X distance from this point, which is at X distance. Which is at a distance X,
either from A or from E. It is also X. Clear to everybody?
So, what will be the value of dip?
Dip will be this one. Clear? This will be the dip. It will be YD.
Get everybody? This one. Not only this. Okay. For stiffen girder, bending moment at any section X. Therefore, since girder means summation of these two, therefore, we have to calculate the bending moment at this point, and we have to calculate the bending moment at this point. Summation of that. Okay. So, first of all, write this bending moment. What is the bending moment? It can be, it is similar to beam moment type of, it will, this figure will give you the what? Beam moment. Is it not? Load W1 वहीं पे आ गया क्या? यहाँ बना दो. No problem. Okay. It is the figure 2 is represented for the beam moment, means mu. Okay. Calculation of VE and VF, it is very simple. It is dependent upon the value of W1, W2, W3. Okay. This load will be defined at certain distances. So the calculation of VE and VF is not a problem. Therefore, this mu at any point can be calculated very easily. Everybody, plus this is from figure number 2. From figure number 1. What is that? It is minus VA into X plus W X square by 2. The same thing? If, and what is this? What is that? If I am taking the minus sign at outside, then it will be VA into F plus WX square by 2. Can we write? Yes. Can we write it as sigma MX? Okay. At this point, WX, can we write it sigma FX? Clear? And can we write it as H into YD? Can we write it as H into YD? Therefore, bending moment at any section, it is mu X minus H into YD. It is similar to It is similar to arc. Ready everybody? It is similar to arc. Therefore, IL for bending moment, it will have the
same type of CPU. Okay. And what will be the value of shear force? This is bending moment and shear force at any section X. Okay, definitely. Differentiate nahi karne yahan se dekho. What is the value of shear force at here? It will be, write it SX, beam shear. SX is SX, mu X, it is the beam moment, mu X, it is the beam moment, and SX, it is the beam shear. Yes, it is, yeah. It is the beam shear. So this one plus this one plus yahan pe shear. Okay, and what will be that value? What will be that value? VE minus any load. VE minus any load on that. Clear? Load agar nahi hai, if there is no any load, then it will have only VE. And here what will be? Minus VA plus WE into X. Plus yeah, minus VA plus W into X. Clear to everybody? Take minus sign out from that. Take minus sign. This. Okay. So this type of thing, this expression is shear force at any. Okay. Acha, bending moment and shear force equation, it is applicable for 2 hinge stiffen girder and 3 hinge stiffen girder, both. Okay, we have not used this point. Use kya kya? No. So this case 1 and case 2, here it is not a case 1. Case 1 will start now. It is general. Now case 1. Case 1 is here. Okay, for 3 hinge. So it is general equation. Okay, now for 3 hinge stiffen girder. Clear everybody? Saamne dekhiye. Yahan tak. Till here. Everything is clear? And out? Okay. Since internal hinge is located at lowest point, and that point, say it is C. Therefore moment at point C equals to 0. Okay, therefore moment, aise likhen, therefore bending moment at X is equal to point C. X is equal to point C. What will be? That will be 0. Okay. Now put that value. Put X is equal to that. Okay. Suppose this is L1. Kya ho gaya? If it is L1. Okay. If it is L1. Here. What is this? This is D1. And this is D2. D2. And what is L1? L1 is this. Okay. This one is L1. this is L1, this is L2.
How L1 and L2 can be calculated? Very easily, there is relation D1 by D2 equals to L1 square divided by L2 square. We know very well that relation.
D1 by D2 equals to L1 by L2 square. We know very well. From that expression, we can calculate that.
Get it, everybody? So the bending moment at that point,
if this is 0, so 0 equals to, we write as mu c minus h into y at point c.
Y d kare na?
Y d at point c.
Y d at point c. D for deep. Ya aisa hi kar de, y c kar de na?
No problem.
That advice. But
that is deep, okay. That should be clear.
Okay. So the value of H is how much?
Mu C by Y.
And it is the ratio of
beam moment divided by deep. कहां पे? At the lowest point. At the lowest point.
At the lowest
point.
Get everybody? So, what you need to make? You need to make this one type of thing. You make this one type of thing. Okay? You do not need to make this. You do not need to make this. You need to make these two figures. Figure 1 and figure 3. Figure 2 only. Get everybody? This is for just understanding. You need to make only this figure 1, figure 2. Only this. Beam moment can be calculated. Value of dip. This dip is basically, this dip is YC. Okay? This is YC, na? This is YC. So the value of H will be calculated. And H is what? H is what?
This
horizontal reaction. Okay, and we know that this value is,
since for cable,
value of H is what?
W E L square by 8D. D means YC here.
Okay, I am writing here YC. Clear? Therefore, mu C by YC equals to WC by mu C by YC equals to W E L square by 8YC. Therefore, value of WE can be calculated. Okay, this is known. Okay, this is known. Since H is known from that equation, capital H is known from this equation. And what is unknown from here? Unknown is only, unknown parameter is only this. So the value of WE will be what?
WE will be H times of 8YC divided by.
Oh, this is the procedure how to calculate the value of WE in 3-inch stiffening girder. This is the procedure how to find that value of WE. How to find the value of WE. In analysis of cable type of thing, that value has been given to you. That value has been given to you. But in actual problem, that value of WE is coming from where? Due to W1, W2, W3. That load is coming from here. Okay? And how you have to calculate? It's very simple. Find out that value. Find out the value of H. First of all, you have to find the value of H. Then equate by WE L square by 8D. Okay, D means here YC. Clear? Find out that. If the value of W is known to you, If the value of W is known to you, then bending moment, this mu x is known to you, mu x is known to you, h is also known to you, y d is known to you, means bending moment calculation of bending moment is over, over now. Calculation for bending moment is over now. Similarly, come to here, shear force, beam, beam shear, no problem. पहले से मालूम था यहां पे, since W is known to you, therefore beam shear, yeah, shear force at that section is also known to you. Got it everybody? Minus VA. Okay, if the value of W is known to us, then the value of VA, this VA, what is that value? VA will be what? W into L1 only. W into L1, this distance L1 na? WE basically. WE. If it is, W is known, then value of VA is known. Value of VA is known. W is also known. X is known. It is given. Therefore, shear force can also be calculated. Therefore, shear force can also be calculated. So this is the complete analysis for the two hinge type of girder. Two hinge shifting type of girder. Three hinge shifting type of girder. Clear to everybody? Clear to everybody? Now, note karke likhne. Note karke likhne. Consider, write equation number 1. Now, give the equation as 1 and 2. So from equation 2, shear force at x is equals to beam shear minus, या ऐसा लिखें VA minus W into x, या ऐसा करें far same elevation, for same elevation of A and B, okay, for same elevation of A and B, as note karke likhe, for same elevation of A and B, it is the part of basically A, which one? Three hinge shifting girder. This is in general when A and B are at the different elevation. Now I am going to discuss when A and B both are at the same elevation, both A and B are at the same elevation. Okay, so the value of h is what? The value of VA is what? It will be WL/2. Hoga nahi? It will be WL/2. Therefore, VA minus W into x will be what? WL/2 minus WE into X. So take the W/2 common. No problem. So this is the value equals to WE into L/2 minus WE into X. Okay, this is the value. If h tan theta. Well, what is the value of h tan theta? So, value of h tan theta is h into dy/dx at any point. Okay? Value of h is WL² by 8D. Value of h. And what is the value of dy/dx? Since we know y equals to 4h/L² x L-6. Okay, this is the shape of the cable. So the value of dy/dx is what? It is 4h/L² L-2x. Clear? Put that value. And h is what? H is d na? H is what? Rise. Here it is dip. So it is 4D divided by L² L minus
2x. Now this one will be cancelled out by 2, L square will be cancelled out by this, then the remaining thing will be what? Remaining thing will be WE by 2 into L minus 2x. Is it the same thing? The VA minus WE into x, and this one, this equation and this equation is same thing, therefore VA minus WX can be written as x tan theta. That I want to tell you. That I want to tell you. Get everybody? Therefore, conclusion. Therefore, for numerical purpose, we will use bending moment equals to mu x minus h into yc, h into yd, and shear force at any section. It will be beam shear minus h into tan theta. Therefore, करके कर लेना. ये है फॉर थ्री हिंज स्टीफन गर्ड. ओके, दैट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर. एंड दिस वन थिंग इज डब्ल्यू ई, थ्री थिंग्स दिस वन और डब्ल्यू ई तो यह है ही. ओके, नाउ केस टू, फॉर टू हिंज स्टीफन गर्ड. Case two. For two hinged stiffened girder, here AB likho main. W is, this is h into 8yc by L square. For two hinged girder, what is the difference? Equation for bending moment at x, it will be mu x minus h into yd. Okay, and shear force at x, it will be Sx minus h tan theta. Both will be same. Ye kiske liye? For same A and B. These two equations are same, no problem, no difference. These two equations remain same. No problem, because these are the general equation. These are coming from the general equation. We did not use any benefit of internal hinge. Use kya kya humne? Nahi kya humne. What is the use of internal hinge? Only to calculate the value of WE ka use kaha? Ye tha na, yahan pe moment zero kiya tha na. It is the ratio of mu c by yc. Okay, here value of WE, it is total load on panel divided by total load on panel of girder divided by the area of girder. This is the total load and the panel of girder divided by what? Passage width of panel. Get everybody? Clear? What is the meaning? this is width, W, this is L. Okay, say total load is W. Say total load is W. Okay, yeah, W bana diya maine isko. Isko B kar dun. Okay. In numericals, that B will be represented by इसको passes या roadway भी कह सकते हैं. इसको this is also roadway. Okay, roadway ही तो है. It is the roadway. So क्या किया मैंने? W is total load W divided by this B, and the unit will be in kilonewton per meter. This type of thing is for किसके लिए? Two engine Stefan girder. This thing is for two engine Stefan girder. And the remaining thing is same, exactly same, nothing different. Remaining thing is exactly same for 2-hinged and 3-hinged. Theory part is over now. We can solve the numerical. We can solve the numerical. Clear?